In Game 2, the Blackhawks knew they had to be physical if they had any chance of winning in Jonois Arena. But the Wings came out flying. Bob Pulford's Hawks came out banging, but the Wings muscled right back. Again, Detroit got the first score from Steve Yzerman.
Yzerman into the Chicago zone, gets by O'Callaghan. The backhand,
he scores! What a goal!
Oh, what a shot by Yzerman!
And the save made by Hanlon.
And now here's Steve Yzerman with a breakaway. All of a sudden, it's Yzerman, he scores!
There were a lot of people that second-guessed Jacques Demers when he made Yzerman captain earlier in the year, but he really came through for this hockey team.
Well, this crowd is getting into it, Bill. We've had the rubber chicken made an appearance on the ice there. I saw my first squid of the evening, and you can hardly hear yourself think in this building now.
Time of cooking penalty. Dombo to Yzerman with Kumpel. Yzerman, slap shot, he scores! Steve Yzerman gives the Red Wings a 1-0 lead, and the Detroit youngster comes up with his fourth Stanley Cup playoff goal.
Mike O'Connell coming up with it and clearing it out of there to Yzerman. He has Anston with him. Yzerman shoots, he scores! Steve Yzerman, and it's 3-1 Detroit.
Paul Coffey now talking with Feuer, asking him if he screened him or not. He did not. It went through the legs.
Push is won by Grant Feuer.
Yzerman with Barr. He scores! Yzerman!
6-4.
Don't go away just yet.
Presley sends it back to the corner. Norwood picks it up there. In 50 seconds, McGill will be out to give the Hawks the man advantage. Yzerman away! Penalty shot fashion. He scores!
Well, Yzerman doesn't miss too many like that. The key play here was the center ice gamble by the Hawks defenseman. You won't see it on this replay. It's already happened. Yzerman right up underneath the bar. That's become his favorite spot.
Klima sends it up the boards. Chiasson pinched in. The Hawks looking for a two-on-one. Good play by Oates to get over there. Oates up the middle now. Yzerman across the line. He's in. Scores! Power play goal! 2-2.
Boy, that was supposed to be offside. Klima cut across in front of Yzerman, barely stayed on the blue line. Yzerman did a little different thing this time with the break.
Into the zone. Checked by Doug Wilson. Hawks able to clear. Gilbert with a hit on McLean. Here comes Yzerman. Let's the shot go. Oh, he hit the post.
He scored. That's in. That is a goal without question.
Okay.
That's in the net. Right on the ice, the hat trick by Yzerman. He doesn't know it's in yet. Van Helleman's going to the penalty bench, and Yzerman says yes or no, and he shakes his head, and it's a hat trick in a 4-3 hockey game. Let's have a good look at it here. Yzerman's right in line with Chevrier. Watch that thing. There it is.
Yes.
No
question
no about
question.
It.
No question.
No question about it. Just inside the post, over the line. Here's the feed from McLean at center ice. Yzerman one-on-one with a Hawk defenseman, McGill, and there's no question that it was in the net.
Back to the point for Oates. Back for Klima, top of the circle. That's a shot, go, save, rebound, and score!
Yzerman.
Yzerman backhands it home on the power play, and the Red Wings get the big goal right back that they needed.
Well, that finally got a rebound that they could get to. Yzerman may have knocked that out of midair. Klima just wheeled around.
Draw comes to the right point. Zombo with a hard shot. It's blocked right back to him. He goes to Koester.
Bingo. Well, let's get to the gate early. Koester will get an assist setting up Yzerman.
Coming from Brad McCrimmon in the first period. Yzerman lays this one along for Bob Probert. Probert stepped in two from behind, casually walks away to Yzerman out in front, backhander, score! Yzerman! And it's 2-0, the Red Wings lead.
You can't keep greatness down. Steve Yzerman can beat you by himself if you give him a chance to.
Hands it back on the point. Across it comes to Doug Crossman. Looks again, Fedorov directing some traffic at the other point. Eisenbart to Yzerman, he scores! Steve Yzerman on the power play, the Red Wings have the lead in the game, 3-0. Probert has Yzerman and headmans it to him. Probert heads for the net. Yzerman a shot, he scores! Steve Yzerman with the hat trick, and it's 6-3.
Boy, I'm impressed with a couple of aspects of this goal.
Up to Yzerman. Knifes it down into the corner. Shepherd in front of the net. Casey's up there.
Well, that move right there is why they call him Silk. Look at Yzerman here. Fakes the shot, pulls it to the backhander, and simply tucks it up high.
And showed his all-star form.
Now Fedorov jumps it to Yzerman. Yzerman shot, he scores!
Second goal of the series for Steve Yzerman.
Great pass by Fedorov. He had his head up, and when Yzerman came in, he was on his forehand side, positioned well. He was in the slot.
They are getting all over this Detroit power play. Here's Fedorov over the Hawk line. Fedorov chipped it loose to Lidstrom. He's open, cutting in. Put it inside of the net to Yzerman. Watch it, open net! He scores! Steve Yzerman walked out from the side of the goal, got around Belfour. There was no other red sweater in front of the net, and he tapped it into a wide-open goal.
Ciccarelli, he got it out. Now Gallant. With Yzerman right behind him. Gallant tried to go in. Yzerman after the puck behind the goal. He shakes off the check.
Who's been the nemesis for the Toronto Maple Leafs for as long as he's been in the league, circles out of the corner as the Leaf player falls down and cuts right across in front and shoots it back to the side.
Onto the tape of Primo. Here's a shot. Close in by Yzerman, blocked. Leafs now just hanging on. The Red Wings with the power play, looking for their third goal of the night. Ciccarelli without the helmet again. Slides it back. Coffey. Chase on to Coffey, off to the boards. Yzerman parked over there, gets a shot, score! 3-0 Detroit, another power play goal.
I don't think Ciccarelli's going to get a point, but he made a point by getting right in front of Felix Potvin, who could not see the point shot.
Todd Gill dropped it back, and it got through the skates of McIlwain. Detroit moving it the other way. This is Coffey. Set up by Coffey, and it is 4-0 Detroit. Look at this brilliant skating by Coffey, turning it on, giving it to Yzerman, and he gets his second.
Yzerman has it there, goes back across for Lidstrom. Lidstrom has a look. He dumps it in front, just missed Yzerman with that pass. Well, the Leafs are doing a lot of spectating now. Cullen throws Yzerman down. Come on, Terry, what are you watching? And he let that go, threw him right off the puck. Here's a steal. Howe, lead pass for Yzerman. Yzerman's got a man coming. Yzerman gets it to Sean Burr. His shot stopped by Potvin, who's down. Burr looking out in front for Yzerman. Yzerman scores! Oh, yeah. Did he ever roof that one?
Bingo.
10.4 seconds. And another shorthanded goal makes it 6-2.
Oh, boy, I'm going to tell you what. What an effort here by Yzerman. He's at the end of a shift, killing a penalty. Second shorthanded goal of the game for Detroit.
Primo trying to protect the puck is dumped to the ice. Yzerman comes in with a hit. Duchesne had it knocked away by Shepherd. 3 seconds left in the penalty. Coffey across for Lidstrom. Lidstrom moving in. Backhand pass. Yzerman scores! It's not a power play goal. But Krupa never got back in the play of the Red Wings with a 5-0 lead as the captain gets his first goal of the series.
Boy, he did not waste any time and any effort on this one, I'm going to tell you. And Yzerman just glowing, waiting for the puck to get there. Lidstrom knew. He made a heck of a move, Lidstrom, on the guy.
It doesn't last very long. 12 seconds later, Wings in the power play. Steve Yzerman is stopped Rebound comes back out to Eisenman, who somehow gets it through the traffic and through Moog. 2-1 wing.
Shot off the post early. Here's Eisenman. Locks in, gives the pass to Airy. They score!
Well, you couldn't have diagrammed this one better up on the chalkboard, as it's just give and go. Eisenman breaking through.
How important the second goal was. One goal deficit isn't bad. Two goal isn't very good, and they saw that in game four.
Boy, Belfour is playing tonight.
Went in underneath the crossbar, dropped dead down, and then was behind Belfour.
Back up to the point, Lidstrom. Shepard trying to go into the middle, dead. Eisenman shoots and scores.
Kick to the boards by Finley. Fedorov attempted to center. It bounces high in traffic. They score! Eisenman was able to jam it past Nikolai Abibul, and that puck bounced high, and as he came out from the corner.
And then Cicerelli didn't know the pass was coming. Here's a steal by Primo. Primo moves in there for Eisenman, and then he couldn't quite corral it. Back of the goal goes Primo. He's Primo center, Eisenman right, and he scores! Steve Eisenman left all alone in the goal mouth. Primo found him, and bang, the Red Wing captain makes it 3-0. And this plays a little bit quieter than it was a few minutes ago.
Well, you know, after what happened Friday night when that man stopped 51 of 52 shots, the Red Wings got to be feeling, thank goodness, that we finally got something to go on this guy.
3.5 minutes gone by in the first. There's no score. Steve Eisenman with the puck. Kings back at full strength. Eisenman moves in. His shot stopped by Casey with a stick. Back behind the net. Eisenman steps it in on the backhand. Quick move by Steve Eisenman. Gives Detroit a 1-0 lead. Took the puck away. Now it's a 3-on-2 Detroit. Eisenman with the puck. Airy to the net. Eisenman holding. On the power play. Matisoff with plenty of room. Lines up. Big shot. Save Casey. And a score. Eisenman on the rebound. And a big battle in front. Watch out here. They are roughing it up now.
Now you can see all this coming at about the 7.5 minute mark. Tony Twist has two players.
John Casey's in the middle of it. Now as he's wrestling down one of the Red Wings, I believe that's Steve Eisenman's paired off with Charlie Huddy. Casey throwing punches now.
Now remember, the Blues were shorthanded, so Casey was the extra player. He was trying to even things up, and you're right, though. He had the player down. He just decided to throw off the gloves and start throwing punches.
That's Tony Twist.
And Fetisov and Adam Creighton on defense as well. There's the last shot. It was deflected. John Casey made the save. And you can see the blue. There's Eisenman coming up for the goal.
And there it goes.
Arion off. Comes back hit over the line. Defender off, turning back to the line. Lidstrom shot right in. There's goal! Lidstrom took the shot from the blue line, and Eisenman was right on the doorstep to score again for the Red Wings.
Hardy coming back in for Detroit. He's ridden into the boards, back to the goal. Eisenman battles for it. Gets it loose. Out front. Casey down, puck is loose, score!
Now the Blues are going to complain.
Crowd doesn't like it, but the puck was loose. It's caught him, Cardinal can't get it out. Wings pass it around, back in front. Kozlov shot right in front of the net again, score! Better off to one side, and Eisenman completes the hat trick. He was open to the other side.
Well, obviously you're going to have more of the quick changes.
on these lines here as we go into this second overtime. Gretzky had it, lost it. Yzerman picks it up. Yzerman moving. Blue line chance. Go! Who's first star of tonight's game? You'll probably see that goal again. For Bill Clement and all of our crew here at the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit, I'm Gary Thorne. Thanks for joining us.
Shanahan wrist shot blocked in front. Conroy looks to clear, but it's held in by Shanahan. Now the backhand attempt by Yzerman sails wide. Lidstrom out to the point for Larionov. Now the return for Lidstrom. He shoots, he scores! Nicklas Lidstrom from the top of the left circle. Second power play goal for the Red Wings this period. And a lonely skate back to the Blues bench for Jim Campbell.
That's a backbreaker for the Blues, but Lidstrom with the rocket from just outside the hash marks. I think it might have hit Steve Yzerman in front.
Gets it back out of trouble. Yzerman dumps it on.
He did.
Wow, took a hop. Steve Yzerman has given the Red Wings the early lead. Oh, my goodness. Who would have ever expected that?
75-foot shot from Steve Yzerman, and wait till you see this thing. Was he near the blue line, or is that the red? That's the red line. So, I mean, that's a 90-footer.
Concentrating so much on defense that even the four-on-four, when there's more room on the ice, a lot of the plays in the neutral zone. They can't get going.
Larionov pulls in on Dan Treble. Drops it for Yzerman. In front, off the skate and in! Tinoff went down and blocked it. Near side. Detmar, Sakic. Sakic tied up by Fetisov. Puck there and Detroit will get it. Yzerman just got away from Rene Corbet. Yzerman moves into the middle. Sandstrom with it. Yzerman. Shot! Save made! Wow! Rebound! Hit! He scored! Steve Yzerman got the rebound! He banked it in! Off the wallet of Patrick Waugh! And Detroit has a 3-2 lead!
What a play by Steve Yzerman. Man, the move that he made to get to the net. Now Mark Crawford wants a review, of course. Who doesn't these days? That's automatic. But the boys in red are loving this. The Detroit Red Wings have overcome a 2-0 deficit in this game by sticking with the game plan and slugging it out, and they finally have a lead.
Steve Yzerman, their captain. Now 105 career playoff games on 106 points.
John LeClair up with Renberg. But that one just punched calmly aside by the defense.
The 3-on-2 that didn't work.
Myers changing, Yzerman shooting, he scores! Steve Yzerman with a bullet! And it is 4-2.
Now the Flyers had a 3-on-2, Mike. Moved up ice, both defensemen were back.
for Detroit. The Flyers changing and a bad goal on Hextall. He's beaten from just inside the blue line with Needham at back. There's the shot, no deflection. Hextall gets beat for a bad one, and the Red Wings have the two-goal lead.
Patisov back over to Larry Murphy. Murphy, Patisov at the top. Slava Patisov shot. Snow the save. Rebound comes to Murphy. Murphy dished it off for Eisenman. Eight left on the power play. Eisenman, his shot, save. Rebound, McCarty. Knocked away by Snow. He scores! With 3 seconds left on the power play, Detroit has taken a 2-0 lead on a power play goal.
And they are 7-0 in the playoffs when they score at least one power play goal in a game.
And one for their last 23. That'll be sent in around for Dykhouse, the defenseman. Couldn't get it out. Kozlov held it in. Detroit will set the power play up with Eisenman in the middle. There he is. Eisenman shot. Score! Steve Eisenman!
Great forecheck by Detroit on the dump in.
Back off for Shanahan. Shanahan dug it in deep. Eisenman there.
He scores!
Steve Eisenman in the last minute of Game 3 tried a similar play, but it was blocked off by the Phoenix Coyotes goaltender Nikolai Hobby-Boulin, but this time he roofed it, and the game is tied at 1.
He wins faceoffs. Doesn't matter if it's defense, offense, it doesn't matter. This guy is one of the very best in hockey, especially in the playoffs.
And the best in the playoffs in that department entering today's game. Puck back to Murphy. Chipped it along for Eisenman, but instead it is handed on for Eisenman, and a backhander had to be kicked out by Pierre. Scramble at the front of the net.
Is a brilliant player in situations. His mind thinks better than a lot of hockey players. He knew where to go. He knew where to go on the draw. He knew where to go without the puck. He knew how to get the puck, and there he knew how to go around the point's leg with a stick to get the puck for the backhand shot.
Red Wings, that power play in such a funk and so important for them. Two goals here tonight. Eisenman looking to center. McCartney goes in. Steve Eisenman will be credited with a goal. He was trying to center McCarty, but it went off Jamie McClellan.
But this time he would. They're down to 7 seconds on the first of the penalties, the one to Bassett. It's dealt back to Lidstrom. Fakes the drive and holds. Eisenman again. Same place. Ricochet off the post and off, and they score!
Reads it, watch him dart in. Look at the puck. Belfour still doesn't know where it is. Carboneau nudges it, and then Eisenman on the second effort got it with his hockey stick.
Game one, he did it too much. Didn't think he had a good game.
Shot by Lidstrom was blocked into the corner. Fedorov will win the faceoff. Fedorov 10 of 24 on the draw. It's in the front. Let's go!
Take it back. It wasn't Fedorov that went to the corner. It was Holmstrom.
Tomas Holmstrom dumped over into the corner.
A little bit of an obstruction. Now the Capitals get the power.
Washington Capitals. Power play opportunity again. Short-handed 2-on-1. Murphy in the middle. Eisenman looking. Eisenman scores! A short-handed goal!
Just like that, the Joe is alive again. Steve Eisenman's seventh multiple goal game in the playoffs.
Off the near side wall. The point goes on top. One timer looks from just wide.
Great players can make something out of nothing.
Chelios leaves it. Wide side Lidstrom. Chelios, he can shoot. Pass that time, far side Shanahan. He was trying to set up Steve Yzerman. Tomas Holmstrom in front. Shanahan shot. Trickle in. By the way, the Detroit Red Wings have a pretty darn good power play, too. What a great decision by Brendan Shanahan to let it rip, because he had demolition man, Tomas Holmstrom standing in front. But let's see how quickly he can get to the bench here.
Olsson from Korea sent it back. Not a good pass because Daniel Solani was tied up. Looked like a set play. Way out of the net, Askey getting back.
A young player's mistake.
He absolutely does. Steve Yzerman, fourth career playoff hat trick. He passes Norm Ullman.
Wendell Clark busting through. Pavel Turenko hooking him. Here's Danino. His shot scores! Deflected in front. Yzerman getting the goal.
I believe so. Yzerman and Shanahan were both there.
It's 5-0.
Yzerman controls. Shanahan moves a little. They try to get it to him. It doesn't work. Yzerman once more. Tested a bit now by Marshall. Puck to the point. Lidstrom back to Yzerman. Fed one for Clark off his skate, though. Taken by Lidstrom again. Over to Yzerman. Yzerman creeps in. Shot save. Another shot. And score! With another huge goal in the playoffs for Detroit, it is 3-2.
Here comes Fedorov, turning tail on second. Fedorov stopping inside the line, Clark to the front of the goal. Chelios to Lidstrom, the Norris Trophy candidate into Yzerman. Yes. Scores!
Short side.
Yzerman, a power play goal, and the Red Wings will stay on the power play for a minute 41.
3 seconds left. On the foot penalty, and Yzerman banked it in off the rear end of Patrick Waugh. And right up underneath the bar, you got the odd man down low with a 5-on-3. That's where they went immediately.
How's that for a poor goal?
I think Patrick Waugh would certainly remember that night as well.
Fedorov with a quick shot. They score at the side of the net. Steve Yzerman was there as Fedorov from the boards, let the shot go, and Yzerman had a wide open net on the rebound.
Another quick chance for the Red Wings, just like the Murphy chance was before the faceoff.
Viewers were watching the action on Fox television in the United States. So technical problems have caused all sorts of grief for people here. There's a goal as it's centered for Steve Yzerman, and he scores his second of the hockey game and eighth of the playoffs.
Again, a quick one, just like the first goal was. Yzerman gets his second goal of the hockey game.
Detroit putting the heat on here on the power play. Alf Samuelson is stuck up. There's Samuelson. Dumped off Tomas Holmstrom. Power play is over. In. Shot.
In this series, but Yzerman's had the better of it. He said because he's lower down on the ground, he's got that base that hurt him. Yzerman, sharp angle, walks in, scores!
Here is Yzerman. He will carry it. He hands it off on the far side at the point, Duchesne. Now it goes in deep for Yzerman. Yzerman wraps around. Oh, puck in down. They score!
a power play goal, and again it's Yzerman. And Cloutier right away complaining that he may have been interfered with, but the goal will stand, and Detroit has taken a 1-0 lead.
And it is fitting, it is more than fitting, that the captain, Stevie Yzerman, score the goal.
In front of the Detroit bench with a shove for Draper. And what a night Matt Cook has had, stirring things up. As has Olin, who lost it here in front. Down, Yzerman scores! Somehow, Steve Yzerman rolled it in, and Detroit regains the lead on a record big breaking goal by Steve Yzerman.
Shanahan, Fedorov, Yzerman up front of the goal, scores! Yzerman now with 7 points in the series, and he's the all-time Red Wing playoff scorer, moving ahead of Mr. Hockey.
Mikhashik has played it all five of the Twins, five in a row. It's empty net. Johnson got back, score! He doesn't get back! Steve Yzerman!
Red Wings on a power play, trying to get their first power play goal in their last 11 chances. That'll be set in by Holmstrom on net. Johnson looking.
Score!
Stevie Yzerman had Johnson shoot that right into his midsection. Sing happy birthday. Here's your gift.
No home. No kidding. That isn't a birthday gift. Nothing is. You know, Brent Johnson's problem started when the puck got caught in the webbing of his glove. Happy birthday, Stevie Y, but Brent Johnson didn't want to hand him the cake with the candles burning right now.
Holmstrom trying to get set up in front. Shot, Fedorov! Missed it again.
I think it might have hit somebody in front, but he sure didn't miss it high.
Boy, that thing screamed to the near side. Shot by Yzerman. Covered with the stick by Patrick Roy on the short side. It's a goal! It's a goal!
Is not arguing. Steve Yzerman was yelling immediately, yes, yes, it's in the net, yes.
Throughout this series, the goals have come early, both in time and in terms of shots. That is on the third shot the Red Wings have. Team scoring first has won 4 out of 5. Centered, score! Another great centering pass, and the captain is on the board.
What a shift for the captain, Yzerman. Mark Eaton, the defenseman, lost his stick. And Yzerman fed that, saw that, noticed it, and took advantage of it.
8 seconds remaining in this penalty as Dandino brings it up ice with some speed. Dandino trying to go wide on Mondador, still has it out, but they score! Steve Yzerman!
Steve Yzerman has not scored a goal in his last 10 home playoff games. The longest drought of his career. Well, guess what? It's over.
Draper taken in against the boards. Yzerman knocks it back in the net for Draper. Draper leaves it for Yzerman. Maltby goes to the front of the net. Yzerman couldn't get it to him. Draper and Commodore tie each other up. Now here's Yzerman. He scores!